special feel in this arena tonight for more reasons than one, but of course, the centerpiece is the former two-division UFC champion, the future Hall of Famer, Conor McGregor, returning to the proven ground here tonight. He fought three times in 2016, just once in 2018. Everybody's excited to see what version of Conor McGregor shows up here tonight.
There are more Irish flags in the building than you'll find anywhere in the United States of America. And it's all for the notorious one. Conor McGregor has taken his country, put it on his back, and rode it to superstardom. He is a fantastic fighter, has really good takedown defense, which allows him to keep the fights on the feet where guys are always in danger. You're constantly in danger whenever you're fighting Conor McGregor, because the moment you attack, that counter left hand is like a piston, and he can shut your lights out with one strike.
Yeah, that McGregor counter left hand, truly one of the best weapons in mixed martial arts today. A master when it comes to movement and distance management. And also just rising to the occasion, right? When all eyeballs are on him, and you've experienced this as well, the ability on fight night to shine.
All the distractions, Conor is able to shut him out, and he goes into the octagon, is focused, and always gets the job done.
DC, here is Kamaru Usman back on the proven ground here tonight, and even dating to the Ultimate Fighter back in 2015, you got the sense pretty early on that we were looking at somebody special. He was able to cap it with the UFC championship. He's back on the horse here tonight.
He has this undying belief in himself. He believes that through hard work, all the results will show, and they have for Kamaru Usman. From the pace and pressure he put on Dos Anjos, to the pace and pressure he put on Woodley, he shows now, and in those fights, why he's one of the best fighters in the welterweight division.
And he's really coming into his own when it comes to his striking. Certainly, he's had a lot of standard influences in his ear. Henry Hooft, of course, Greg Jones on the wrestling side. Kamaru Usman, as he put it way back in the day, is a real problem.
Let's keep it up.
Set to fight the notorious Conor McGregor. Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! Five rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the former UFC featherweight champion of the world, and the former UFC lightweight champion, the notorious Conor McGregor! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the former UFC welterweight champion, Kamaru, the Nigerian Nightmare, Usman.
Herb Dean, third party in the octagon tonight. All right, so the moment has arrived for this capacity crowd and fight fans around the world. Yes, it shall be done. Kamaru Usman and Conor McGregor, and if you know Conor, he's not fazed.
Conor is not afraid of anything. He is a psycho. But why not be a psycho when you possess those types of abilities? Conor McGregor's left hand is as fast as damaging as any single strike we have seen in UFC history. But can he land it against the bigger Kamaru Usman? Or is Usman going to use his wrestling to ground Conor? Man, so many questions, and I cannot wait for them to be answered.
Man, these guys have some chins on them. Huge shots being landed on both sides.
This might be a real good job with the jab right now.
Well, as usual, this outstanding striker has come out aggressively tonight, almost as if he's double parked outside.
Dude's trying to get the job done and get it done quickly. But he doesn't waste any action. Everything is so tight and crisp. That's why he lands, and he can be so aggressive.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Kamaru Usman. Great connection right off the gut, DC. He's in a world of trouble now.
They say the straight moves are the ones that get there first, and it got right to the target.
Big uppercut. Oh, big knee to the body.
Oh, big elbow.
Oh, how many knees can one man take? So pretty good recovery by the opponent after getting stunned pretty good. Got to capitalize on those opportunities.
I mean, you can't waste these opportunities. You don't get them as often as you'd like. So when you get a guy hurt, you got to find a way to finish the fight.
Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked. McGregor gets touched by that kick right to the body there. Nicely done by the opponent. Beautiful strike there as he continues to attack that cut. Cut man's going to have some work to do if we get to the stool between rounds.
But that's why we got the best in the business. We got the best cut man in the business. And they are going to need him right now because this cut is getting worse. And it's only going to continue to get worse because he has got a killer in front of him.
Well, defense doesn't necessarily win championships in MMA, but he's doing a nice job blocking these shots.
He's not allowing his opponent to get any damage off of him by blocking all these attacks.
45 seconds remain in the round. Oh, McGregor's cut on his nose, manageable for a while, maybe not so much now. That thing is pouring blood. All right, 20 seconds to go in the round. Almost in range with the straight left, but that's a miss.
That's the danger in the engagement there.
Round two straight ahead. All right, so that's the end of the round. All right, so now we have some real adversity. There's a cut on the nose.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Second round underway. On display from Kamaru Usman as he lands yet again there.
Kamaru Usman showed in the Colby Covington fight, not only is he the best welterweight in the world, he may just be the toughest welterweight in the world because he went through the fire in order to retain that title.
McGregor's cut right on the bridge of his nose does not look good, folks. We'll continue to keep an eye on it. How about the accuracy to land right there? His opponent's wobble chin.
He's hurt bad. He cannot take another shot like that.
Strong outside leg kick. Oh! Beautiful combination! Just looked like it did stun him a little bit.
Nice takedown defense.
Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Well, it's been a wild fight thus far. Perhaps a contender for some bonus money at fight's end. These guys are going to have to dig deep. They're both hurt.
They're both hurt. You expected it, though. You expected a close fight. You did not expect a war like this, though, where both guys, from the moment they said fight, went forward, got in each other's face, and just beat each other up. It's been tremendous.
Immediately gets the underhook. Well, the calf kicks all the rage, but he's not discriminating, attacking the thigh pretty effectively here.
Yeah, we have seen that. Oh!
Gets back to his feet. Watch the ball.
Back in the room, these two guys are trading huge shots. Let's get them out here.
McGregor's an absolute mess. I wonder if they might call in the ringside physician and potentially stop this fight. punches he's thrown all night. The ref is going to step in here and call on the doctor to look at what is a now mangled nose. This could be the end of the fight.
It could be the end of the fight. There's a lot of blood. The blood's going down into the mouth. I mean, the nose could be broken.
Yeah, and he wants to continue, but he will not be afforded that opportunity. So that is it. Fans don't like it, but the doctor has to protect the fighters. The official decision is inside the octagon. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has called a stop to this fight, declaring the winner by TKO, Kamaru, the Nigerian Nightmare Usman.
Kamaru Dean Usman. We'll shorten it. Congrats, Kamaru. Big effort out of him tonight.
Big effort, and it's become the norm. Every time he steps in the octagon, you know that he's going to give you 110%. Most times, that is enough to get the victory. Once again, Kamaru gets his hand raised.